Vikram bhai, we have seen Virat Kohli, particularly in T20 cricket, there is a sort of switch that gets flipped, and towards the end he can accelerate. Almost the best in the world. What is it, as a batting coach, have you had any conversations with him? What happens? When does he generally has tended to do it in the last 5 or 6 overs, but is there a particular trigger, or is it the match situation, or what actually causes that switch to flip?
It's definitely the match situation. I mean, he's the most experienced batsman for us in the team, and of course he assesses the situation and the conditions. And when to change gears, I think it's definitely based on what the situation the team is in, and when to, when he wants, when he feels that he can take the bowlers on.
Vishesh Roy, then Swarup, and then Kushan Sarkar.
Hi Vikram sir, Virat just talked about how important KL Rahul is in the batting scheme of things. How do you see a batsman who has recorded 3 failures, and how important is it for you to tackle him in a good manner, because he's been beaten by a Mark Woods pace?
Of course, anybody can have a lean phase. Last 1 year, I think KL has been our best batsman in the T20 format. He's averaging more than 40 plus, and with a strike rate of 145. So 3 failures does not change that fact that he's maybe the best batsman we have for this format, and he has done really well for us the past year. So I think this is the time, as a team, we need to support him, and absolutely sure that he'll come back out this lean phase that he's going through.
Sorry, my name question, sir.
I lead to that question only, that how as a coach do you work with players like some of the white ball specialists who are probably for 3 months they didn't have any game time. So it also becomes a case of rustiness because they didn't have time in the middle like some of the others had 6 test matches or 5 test matches. So how as a coach do you tackle that kind of an issue?
The only
Game
thing,
time.
yeah, the only thing, I mean, I agree with you. I mean, it's they do get a little rusty, I think, when they're sitting out. The best we can do is keep providing them practice. They've been having a lot of net sessions, and they have been batting in the middle also. We've been having net sessions in the middle on the side wickets there. So that's all they can do, and we just hope that, 1 inning and 1 shot, and he'll be back in form. People like KL Rahul, I'm talking about. Yeah.
So there's one question on chat, and I read it out. It's from Ashwin Anji. We have seen that the team's batting first has struggled in this T20 series. Is the pitch tricky to bat on in the first innings compared to the second innings?
It is actually, it's a difficult surface to assess. So what will be a good score, and the bounce, it's a little sticky when you start batting. So the ball stops. Today also we saw some variable bounce. So it is a tough surface to bat first, I think, and to assess how many runs will be a good score. But that's what we are getting, and every game we played on different surfaces. So again, as a batting team, as a team which is batting first, I think it's a little tough. But we have to, I mean, it's played 3 games now, so hopefully next game we can do better in case we bat first.
Master Farid and Subhan Chakraborty.
Hello, Vikram. So I just want to know, like, given India's resources in batting, and thanks to IPL, the number of players who are coming up, do you think somehow that is creating a problem with the problem of plenty of players there? And is that actually clotting the team, like who to go for and who should not go for?
Not really.
Because it's just.
That's a good problem to have, I think. It's great that we have this kind of bench strength. People are doing well. We have a lot of players who can fill up the places in case we need them. But again, we know we as a team management, I think we understand which is our best 11, and those are the players we need to back. So unless there's a real big fall off in form or some injury, I think we should stick to our best 11, and hopefully they'll come good.
Subhan.
Hi Vikram bhai, my question is, Virat Kohli came to bat at number 4 today. So is it a long-term option going forward, Virat Kohli batting at number 4, given the range he has?
Nothing is long term. I mean, we're just experimenting. This is the last series before World Cup. I think these could be the last few T20 games that we are playing before World Cup. So we're just experimenting a little. We're just trying a few options, and we'll see where Virat needs to bat. He's somebody with his experience. He can bat at any number. We're sure of that. But we'll see closer during the World Cup where we want him to bat, where the team needs him to bat.
Last point, yeah. Anshul Gupta.
Hey Vikram.
Hi.
So my question was, does the problem of plenty affect the players who are playing in the 11, because they know that if they fail in one or two matches, they will be replaced or they might be replaced?
I don't think so. I mean, that's the key. I think as team management, we need to keep giving them that confidence that, you know, whoever is our player or whoever is the player we feel will do the job for the team, he should be playing. And you know, people go through lean phases. That happens in cricket, and sometimes you will get out early. But as if we are talking about KL Rahul, so he's done so well for us in the past year. So a couple of failures does not change the fact that he's one of the main players that we have for this format.
Final question now, Surya Vaidya. Yes, Sunil ji.
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yes, yes, we can.
Hello?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. You've been talking about experimenting before the World Cup, this is the last series. So will you be experimenting in last two matches about your lineup, like giving chance to bowlers like Saini or batsmen like Suryakumar Yadav, those who are in this team and haven't got chance, so you've got two more matches to give them chance. Will you be doing that? So that's the experimenting that we'll be doing.
That's the discussion I don't think team management has had so far. So we'll see. We have a day to go for the match. So I think that discussion will take place tomorrow, and then we'll see what the team needs at this stage.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.